It's April 8, 2016. I'm your host, Dana Dernford, the nuclear proctologist.org. And you can find these videos and Fukushima presentations throughout the entire internet. We are very proud and pleased, enjoyed, overjoyed to be able to say stuff like that. We encourage that. It's copyright free, everything I'm doing. And that this is season 3, episode 15. It's like season 4, episode 5,000 or something, but we've done 260 days on the ocean, 15,000 miles of the coastline, and so the episodes are far apart and everything else. And so Unit 3, MOX fuel, and I know there's a lot of confusion over that, and I kind of get that, and I should be more on the ball when I'm talking about stuff like that. Particularly explaining it for people to make sure everybody can kind of wrap their mind around it. And so yesterday we were talking about Unit 3, and I never get a chance to finish all the material I put together. I have so much, just an incredible amount. And because we cover a voracious amount of topics in a very short while, 1 hour period. This is Thomas Ackerman's painting before we left on the Beak expedition, where we had 4 people and we went out and started the really exploratory part of it with a boat. And that's an important picture. Today we're going to talk about Unit 3. I think I found a higher quality Unit 3. No, I got the wrong one there already. Nice start, Dina. Well, Unit 3 detonated. And this was what was left, basically. And this is supposed to be 720, we're streaming today. And 720 with the same bandwidth, but it should give us a little bit higher quality. I'll be recording it in 720, super high quality. That's a 100 gigabyte file for 1 hour. And I'll crunch that to a 1080, 4 gigabyte file. And then I'll upload that. It'll be very high quality, very good audio. And it looks like I lost my way already this morning. That's fine. That's because we had to set up. I've been working all day since yesterday, trying to get this up and running and organized and proper. And so, a little loud that time. I'll turn it back a little notch. I'm just watching my meter. Unit 3 is the one in the right-hand corner. And Unit 3 is the one in the middle. Now, the 3 reactors that you see in that picture there, the one on your left is Unit 2. That's now confirmed, all gone, 100% meltdown, melt through, melt out. The middle one is the same. One, as you can see, it's all gone. Everything's gone. The reactor cores that were stored on the roof are all gone. And that there was so much pollution, they got thousands and thousands and thousands of massive temporary containers that only meant to last for a year or two. And they picked up 30 million. That's 5. If you put one of them in the back of a pickup truck, that's 5 lanes of traffic around the planet. From 4 buildings. From 4 buildings. Now think about that. How could you get 30 million bags, 1-ton bags, that only meant to last a year, from 4 buildings? That's just significant, incredible. Well, what happened was number 3. This was mixed oxide fuel. And it's a painful process for people to understand, because I've been trying to convey in layman's terms the aspects and facets of it. And you'll hear me slurping away. You can sue me for slurping when you get around to it. And good morning, everybody. I didn't say good morning to everybody. Let's come over. Well, that works out. Let's move me. Shift me somewhere else. About that way. That's not going to work very well. Dana. You got to get with the program. You're getting tiny, Dana. Where'd you go now? Okay. We kind of want to get the pictures below me in too at the same time. There we got everything else going on. If I'm reading headlines, the pictures of the building before me gives you a lot of context. Right, that gives you context, yeah? Just like 30 million bags should give you context. Well, you're on a three, so let's get come over and say hi. Good morning, everybody. So you can see this morning the quality's a lot different, I hope, on your end. I'm sure it's not going to be super high. Hang on. But it's definitely going to be a higher quality for the recording after that we post. Looking forward to that. Really high quality. I've been trying to do this for how many months now? 3 months. Trying to get this to work. It's endless every day. Every day is about a 1 hour stream. That's in my life. My whole life is about a 1 hour stream. Because that's how important the topic is. Good morning, Candace, Bruce, Terry Ann, Ping, Albert, Sparrow, Ackerman. There you go, bud. That was Thomas painting I showed everybody at the beginning of it. For the Expeditions for Life, which is a sad thing, right? And you'll find Thomas's link under my Beautiful Girl by Dana YouTube videos. I'm Beautiful Girl by Dana on YouTube. Shanigan, Illusion is over. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, painting the documents, the efforts of the most important anti-nuclear activists ever. Thank you, Thomas. Hugs for you, my friend. But, like, the reality of it is, you know, I don't exist without all ye, without every one of you folks that supported me, that are here rallying right now, that are worn down and worn out and brutalized and beaten down by a system that floods you with disinformation and misinformation. So E&E News, Cole shut down last night and left a comment there. He said he was talking about, I'm more than willing to reconsider my estimates, which are only widely ballparked. In fact, I'm confused on the issue. Okay. First, let me repeat, the Becquerel count isn't any measure of biological danger. What? What planet did you just pop out of, man? You've been at this a long time. Even if all the radioactivity from all the radionuclides add up to 10,000 becquerels a cubic meter, it would only equal the background radiation. No, background radiation is normal, everyday, stupid, indigenous, harmless, retarded, idiotic, moronic. Normal, everyday background radiation is harmless. It don't mean nothing. But if you put another Becquerel in there from man-made, it means something. That's why we're worried about dirty bombs. That's why we have nuclear waste sites. It means something. You don't need to get 10,001 man-made in an area with 10,000 to over-equal it. One Becquerel of man-made is worse than 10,000 natural stuff. The natural stuff you can't accumulate anymore. It's homeostasis. Your body can only has a limited, as everything, your clothing, material, the potassium 40 in this, is irrelevant. When you add man-made to it, no matter what isotope it is, out of the 12,000, okay, so it would only equal the background radiation. That's the biggest disinformation imaginable. So he swallowed a hook, line, and sinker, or he's a troll, one or the other. I suspect he's a troll myself, but I could be wrong, because you can't be that stupid after all the time he's put in there, I don't think. If you find, say, 10 becquerels a meter cube of 137, do you think you would find a total over 10,000 becquerels of total fallout? But you would find close to 12,000 becquerels for potassium. Potassium means nothing. It's nothing. It can't mutate a fruit fly. It's normal. It's not an emitter. It doesn't come from a chain reaction. It doesn't cause cancer. It's natural. Your body, if you eat bananas with potassium 40, your body equalizes and gets rid of the 12 becquerels you just consumed. It uses it up too, right? For lack of a better way to technically walk you through the jargons. So the cesium is dangerous at 10 becquerels a meter cube. No. An atom in your body, nuclear is the most carcinogenic thing on the planet. That's why you have terrorist laws. That's why we're worried about dirty bombs. That's why we have nuclear waste sites. That's what a big whoop over you got, Mountain. But it's important I cover this. Again, he says, people, even scientists, look at the Becquerel number and think that 10,000 Becquerel is more dangerous than 10 Becquerels. But we know this isn't the case, right? Since there are nearly 12,000 Becquerels a meter cube in the ocean naturally. That's irrelevant. Natural stuff is irrelevant. So, and life did fine with this amount. That amount is, that's the max. That's the lowest and the maximum number the body can hold. That's what the body holds. Yeah, you can get deficiencies, but your body is emitting nothing. It's not going to mutate something. It's not dangerous. Every insect, every creature, everything we eat, everything we touch, everywhere we go, everywhere we sit, everything in our, every aspect of our life, potassium-40. It's irrelevant. We are in harmony with it through genetic superior selections. But that is the biggest lie of the nuclear industry. Oh, there's 10,000 becquerels of natural stuff in you. I don't know why you're worried about 10, because a single atom is attacked in your body. It sequesters in your organs, your muscles, your bones. That's important. Because what he's telling people there is completely, unimaginably, right out of the PR handbook. 100%. And I disrespect him for doing it. He does it over and over and over and over. So there's a lot of people at E&E News. And people will go in and talk with them. Oh, I get it. They're the same ones that are supposed to be articulate and helping people coming to E&E News comment section looking for helpful tips. And they got to read through that nonsense, and then they come over and argue and fight and disregard the stuff I say. Oh, Dana, why are you worried about 10 becquerels? You got 10,000 natural in your body. I seen it at E&E News. No, you didn't. You seen it in the comment section by a PR firm, most likely. I'm calling them out. MOX plutonium fuel used in reactor 3, 2 million times more deadly than enriched uranium. Now, Dana, they only use 6%. Okay. Now, if I take a 6-gallon bucket, bear with me. I take a 6-gallon bucket, and I got, and I make wine. And the wine's around 6%. Now I add in 4 bottles of whiskey. Okay. That's a big difference, isn't it? Now, say I added in just a bottle of moonshine. Bigger difference again, isn't it? But now I added in moonshine that was triple, quadruple distilled. You know, like 4 bottles of that, say, for instance. Or 1 bottle of it, or half a bottle of it. Now, now when you drink 3 glasses of that wine, what happens to you? Now you get hammered. Where you would drink 8 glasses and you'd be sick and you have a headache in the morning, but you'd be okay. But when you added all that moonshine or any other kind of adjective to enhance it, it's like fracking where they use depleted uranium that makes the explosive 8 times more powerful. Just a gram or so in a whole bunch of explosives. They sprinkle it through with all the explosives. Well, that's what they've done with the mixed oxide fuel to reclaim plutonium uranium from reactor 3 in Japan. The building below me that blew all of its reactor cores off the roof, atomized and aerosolized, and spread it all over the country, let alone all over the Fukushima prefecture site. So when you added, when you took missiles from silos that were 40 or 50 years old, and you put them through a chain reaction, already, right, to get the missiles, the nuclear missiles. Now they sat, and think about how wine sits there and ferments, or, you know, if you don't, when you're originally making it, how malt and everything else would ferment, right? That's how you make it. Well, nuclear, when you let that happen to it, it becomes unstable. It becomes more deadly, becomes more oxidized, becomes more more volatile as time goes by when it's in that form itself where it's not down, what you call downblending it, right? That's the way they downblend plutonium, is to separate it so it's not in a package. Because when it's in a tight package like that, it's putting out neutrons and x-rays. And so that's not only bombarding all of the missile, the fissionable product, with neutrons and x-rays, that's what makes it so volatile. Because it already went through a chain reaction, had that done. But when you put it through a chain reaction again, after you reclaimed it through a very sophisticated enriching program, where it was like you took wine and you kept adding bottles of moonshine all day long. So 6% of that Now, the fuel rods, each reactor has 4,840 assemblies. I can't remember the exact number, if that's right. 4,800, it works out to 288,000 rods. Each rod is 12 feet long and 18 pounds. And each one of these rods, the 288,000, that you only got a two-year lifespan at most, usually around 18 months, you put that up on the roof, 5 million pounds. Not 1,000 pounds, not 1,000 rods, 100,000 rods, but every 18 months, almost 300,000 rods. And that's six reactors each doing that. Each one of them individually takes 5 million pounds, right? Over 5 million. But anyway, what the mixed oxide is you took this reclaimed uranium too and plutonium. Now, MOX will produce plutonium. Yeah, Dana, we're eating up the plutonium. Actually, you're producing plutonium, more dangerous plutonium, more of the more volatile daughters of the plutonium. And so when you take your fuel rods, which are all pellets, and you got mixed oxide, that's why they call it mixed oxide, because it's mixed in with this. And so this is putting out enormous energies. It's already gone through a chain reaction. It's already, and then it was reclaimed through sophisticated techniques and technologies where it become extraordinarily volatile. Then when you mix that throughout the fuel cycle, the 5 million pounds, and you switched it on, it was on for 6 months, I think. So that stuff in particular, at unit 3, all of it is considered MOX fuel. Now, just not talking about the stuff that was on the roof or the previous stuff that the reactor, the 5 million pounds every 18 to 2 years that it chews up, that is all stored on the site. That's 30 million pounds every 2 years. And it's 400 train car loads to get a gram. That's why they have to lie to you and tell us like a potato chip and a banana. Because 400 train cars are cannibalized of iron ore with chemicals. And then that's mixed with incredible amounts of water to get a gram, which is a million watts. It's a pretty neat trick, but you know, not as neat as trick as getting rid of 400 train car loads of chemicals and iron ore. And then unbelievable amount of water that you put in the slurries around the sites and allow to evaporate into the environment. Everything left is toxic sludge. Everything that evaporated is toxic air, is toxic particles and elements and atoms circulating through the environment, being liberated back into the environment. So mixed oxide fuel is when you blend it in reclaimed uranium, not just plutonium, see? Because people will confuse you and say, oh, they only got 6% plutonium in there. But they actually had a whole lot more of reclaimed uranium, the 235, the fissionable product, right? Because that's what they covet. But 238 is not a fissionable product, but 238 can be converted into plutonium, see? And plutonium is man-made. And it's the most dangerous stuff on the planet. And we've covered the studies in Dr. Raymond Gilmedy from Loveless Respiratory Research Institute in New Mexico, who got 94 peer-reviewed studies of killing beagle dogs and beagle puppies with neptunium, plutonium, and americium, and curium. And curium is the biggest byproduct of the fuel rods. And there's 288,000 fuel rods per reactor per two-year cycle max. And the reactors weren't running at super low cycle for 27 years. They were running at high peak cycles for 27 years to produce the wattage to give them street creds to get more reactors. They pushed them hard and they pushed them long. Yeah? And so every 2 years is 30 million pounds. But if you go look at the official numbers they talk about 100,000 rods, which is not enough to run a single reactor. So what happened to all the many years of production for six reactors, see? Right? And so plutonium is its own creature. Is what I'm saying to you. In camera two, MOX plutonium fuel used in Fukushima reactor 2 million times more deadly than enriched uranium before it goes through a chain reaction. But the stuff that was in the mixed oxide fuel at reactor 3 had already went through a chain reaction 50 years ago. It was already 2 million times worse. You put it through a chain reaction again, it's another couple of million. But it's actually more than that because it's reclaimed uranium and plutonium. It's not like you took it out and put it in a chain reaction again. You reclaimed it, put a sophisticated system, and then you blended it. And now this stuff is outputting power that if you sat down in a chair or Geiger counter that measures it coming out of your body, you'd probably break it. Now this also material, because there was 5 million pounds in that reactor, so there was also that would explain why we're seeing the black mold, which is a million becquerels a kilogram or a square meter on the surface, throughout northern Japan from Tokyo, at least all the way to northern Japan. And all the food in all of northern Japan from Tokyo, including Tokyo, is banned in most countries, but not all countries. So yeah, you can get it from different countries, but if you look at the whole province, it's all banned when you look at the world, because the world doesn't see the whole picture. They just find out that there's a lot of radiation in that prefecture, this prefecture, so they banned it there. But they didn't go down the rabbit hole and look at the whole country like we done. And we covered 9,000 headlines before we went on the ocean on the Fukushima Expeditions for Life. And so that's why I had to do another stream today, because there's so much involved in the Unit 3. So many aspects of it. So hang on. What about the plutonium MOX? The media tells us the things are looking much better now in regards to Japan. This was March the 25th. This is basically apologist, but does tell some truth. And so the media tells us the things are looking, yeah, there's something bothering us in London which makes it difficult. Hang on. What does the smoke and vapor being emitted from the plant actually contain? So that's an important one. Right? That's important. Dan, I can move yourself over. It's just because I spun. Let me fix that for everybody. I'll just move myself over a little tiny bit. So do you think a little bit got out of there? Or do you think it's all gone? Huh? That's why they got 30 million bags. That's why there's that black, crazy, mass murdering stuff all over the country. To your left is Unit 3. There's Unit 3. Fukushima iodine is a tracer, and so that meant there was 10 times more iodine-132, 30 times more iodine-133, 31 times more iodine-129. That's what that means to anybody who knows anything about this. And then you had the Norwegian Institute for Air Research showing a plume right across the country. Northern Hemisphere during a relatively short period of time. Yeah, because it only takes 3 days because the jet streams are real. And because the hotter the detonation, the hotter, like a forest fire, a big forest fire will send plumes further because there's more heat. As Unit 3, there's no fuel pool, no reactor left, it's all gone, see? Right? These were serious nuclear detonations. These were events. Let's come back for a second, though. What if one of the elements being discharged is plutonium? What if all of the elements are being discharged or a mixed oxide contaminant? Because there was plutonium in all the reactors, right? In at least 1, 2, 3, and 4 that we know about, around 500 kilograms in each of it. The implications of that is mixed oxide in all of them. And so this is why I advocate all the particles, in one sense, from Fukushima, are hot particles. Because we got that documentation, that is exactly what was going on. Reactor 3, your third sentence down. And MOX is far more dangerous than uranium. MOX is 2 million times more deadly than normal enriched uranium. 2 million times. It's 2 million times worse than any other reactor on the planet. That's what that means. That's what the headlines were for the first couple of weeks. You notice they purged that off the internet. But for the first couple of weeks, even a couple of months, there was huge debates in Fox and CNN and MSNBC, not debates, but conversations about MOX being 2 million times worse than any current reactor on the planet, which is in the interpretation of the pundits from the documentation that we're showing you here. Workers were evacuated from the nuclear plant after smoke appeared at Reactor 3. Mixed oxide. Because you walk through a plume of that, it's game over, and it was. No radiation spike has been detected on the comet, so the comet assumption is all is fine. That all is fine. Nothing was detected, eh? You believe these people? No, nothing detected. Meanwhile, this is a plume based up on a man-made release from Unit 2 that didn't look like Unit 3. Right? That still looked like it was intact. But this was a two-day release from that reactor. But that release you're looking at covered North America right across the Pacific Ocean, heading over to another country. That reactor was not based upon this building. That model was not based upon this building. Why not? The models have never been based upon the reactors at Fukushima. So Japan was hit by a 9.0 earthquake. We watched the roads cracking in Japan, in Tokyo. We watched the road lifting up and down. We watched the media come out in Japan and report on the damage throughout Japan. It was a couple of thousand buildings, 100,000 buildings destroyed. Roads were picked up and destroyed. Bridges were destroyed. The whole country was destroyed. This lasted 6 minutes, and that it hit the country at 9,000 miles per hour. It rocked the country for 6 minutes at 1 to 3 G forces. The tsunami came in at 600 miles an hour, and it wiped out most of the coastline. And so people died throughout that coastline because the tsunami came through and ripped them apart, right? And if you want some more stuff on the tsunami, I'll bring you up some more stuff on the tsunami. Because the tsunami, that whole country, this is as it's showing up and coming in, now it's starting to sweep boats apart, right? But no, this was an apocalyptic hell. No matter how you try to look at it, if you were one of the children or family members in another country looking at that, you would have been terrified. But what about you were the millions of people directly affected by that? And then all the telephone poles, the entire country was washed away. The entire country was wrecked from one end right to the other end, yeah? Completely annihilated. Just ask her. There was over 300 police officers doing that job, died of heart attacks and renal failure, liver failure, kidney failure, gland failure. This is probably the most frightening picture imaginable besides that girl by herself. That always haunts me, that one. That one there, that haunts me. And the very day I saw it, till even today, many years later, it still haunts me every time I look at it. And that should haunt you. I can assure you, that haunted the person that painted this picture. It haunts the family of those 300 police officers. It haunts everybody that was sitting on a roof that night looking at that. And it haunts me looking at that. What you're looking at is 6 million times Chernobyl. It's as simple as that. But we're not counting the fuel pools full of reactor cores every 18 months, 5 million pounds, that was on the roof of the building that don't exist no more. And that Chernobyl is insignificant. Even though Chernobyl was horrible, it was terrible, it was unimaginable, it's still and will be till the end of our human experience be unimaginable. There's 3 million children, according to Kofi Annan, with permanent disabilities because of Chernobyl. But Chernobyl was graphite. Graphite is totally different than what we see going on here. What we see going on here, the mixed oxide fuel, is a highly volatile fuel. The plutonium is a gas when it's exposed to the environment. You don't need a detonation. A detonation doesn't hurt. But when you blend it throughout 5 million pounds in pellets, you irradiated everything by proxy. That's what makes this stuff. That's why they were doing what they were doing. He changed the shroud on it so it can burn. But plutonium can burn 150,000 times hotter and did. And so the way everything that was on the roof was engulfed and melted down, the majority of it could have hopefully melted down into the earth. And I say that lightheartedly. And it's better than aerosoling and atomizing, ionizing and radiating everything it comes into contact with till the end of time. And there's so much, there's such a big volume. It's such a See, man-made per gram is 88 times 37 billion killer atoms. Each one of them can kill you, but it might take 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years to show up for cancers. That's the mouse in the room. There's 1,800 diseases can show up and will show up once you got the atom inside of you. But you can eat bananas every day and get potassium in everything you're eating. It's not going to hurt you. It's not going to bioaccumulate in you. It's not going to manifest in the tumors or diseases or autoimmune deficiencies. But all the man-made stuff, from the studies on Dr. Raymond Gilmedi, who killed beagle dogs and beagle puppies for 35 years, they never once, in 94 peer-reviewed studies, tried to cure the cancers, and that they killed all the dogs within 5 years in every study. He's one of thousands of institutions utilizing dogs and puppies and animals for man-made radiation studies for 70 years that we know about. Have you never tried to cure cancer a single time? Ever. And their idea of curing it is a sick, pathetic, mass murdering scheme known as chemotherapy. Anybody gives their chemotherapy to their loved ones, that's murder. You might not understand it, and you might not agree with what I'm telling you, because you don't understand it. But that's why we have terrorist laws, that's why we have nuclear waste sites, not to put it in your loved ones' bodies. That's stupid and idiotic and mass murder on a grand scale in every hospital throughout Canada. They do that to people. They'll take your children away from you to give them chemotherapy. That's how powerful the nuclear industry really truly is. They can kill your children, and they do. If you're going to get chemotherapy, you've got to sign a waiver, though. To sign away your life, that if you die during these experimental treatments. Now, everything that comes out of that reactor you're looking at is mixed oxide fuel. It's all blended together, though. That's the point C of the plutonium, right? That's why they got to change the shrouds on these places, because they get so hot. I'm going to have a cigarette. It doesn't have 7,000 chemicals. But for 50 years, everybody's been telling you in all the institutions and media, nicotine gives you cancer. But not once has they got a study that does that. But they ignore the 7,000 chemicals. See, they don't take a cigarette, remove the 7,000 chemicals, and do a study on the nicotine. They get nicotine from natural tobacco. That's what I'm smoking right now. If you don't like it, you can fuck off. Go away. I don't care about you. If you can't look past me having a cigarette without 7,000 chemicals, get the fuck off my channel. I got no time for people like you. I look past all of your flaws to try to help you, but you can't look past any of my flaws. And in fact, you go the opposite and use it to demonize me and ridicule me. Not even talk about the 7,000 chemicals. Just stick a comment in Dean is smoking, I can't trust him. And never bothered mentioning the 7,000 chemicals that got me addicted originally, that no one bothered telling me about, that no media has ever told you about. And that over the last couple of years, we've seen the advertisement from organizations showing up, showing studies that there's 7,000 chemicals in your cigarette. You can't trust your media, and you can't trust your universities. You can't trust your institutions. That is shocking on its own, see? That is hopelessly shocking. And that is maniacally depressing. Because they got access to our loved ones and our friends and our families through the media. Your institutions do. And that your children go to these institutions where if they're willing to lie to you about something like this, they're willing to rape and molest and destroy your children. Don't think they won't. Because that's why they got the job in the first place, is because they're soulless and heartless. That's why they work at a university. Because they're willing to bow down when called upon. When there's an accident, they're willing to come out and make a lie true. Because, I'm a professor, why would I lie to you? It's done in every university in literally every democratic country. If that's not the order of betrayal, I don't know what is. You cannot trust a university. You're an idiot, a moron, if you trust your university. You're a hopeless dummy. There is no hope for you if you trust your university and your institutions. If you when there's an accident, if you go to them for knows, they might tell you the truth originally, a little bit, and then they'll roll it to banana peddlers and the potato chip peddlers, and the voodoo peddlers from the media won't have another narrative dare to cross examine them. Nobody will ever have another narrative, only bananas and potato chips and walking in the sunshine wherever they give a lecture. They won't get on a stage or get on the media or get in a radio fight or a TV or a Twitter battle with anybody that calls them out. That's James Hansen. That's disgusting. He's a disgusting Megan and a parasite upon our society. And that's what 350.org is. They're able to rally thousands of universities to advocate for nuclear, to get rid of coal, gas, and fuel, oil, saying, oh, it's going to destroy the planet when nuclear is guaranteed. Has already wrecked the Pacific Ocean, killed the Pacific Ocean. It's killed the Pacific Ocean. We've done 260 days on the coastline. 5 months without coming home on the ocean. 15,000 miles is up at the nuclear proctologist. If I can find it. That's not it, I can assure you. Sometimes I don't know who the hell I am. Hang on. Nuclearproctologist.org. I can't go through a couple of 100,000 pictures on my site when I'm live streaming. Live streaming is about that camera there. Live streaming is about engaging a population that is out there right now looking for more information, and about building a community of people that are knowledgeable and able to go out and do battle, about educating journalists and scientists that there's another way forward. And anything, you can burn car tires in your house, is still better than having a nuclear plant next door to you. I'm not kidding you. It's safer. It's not safe, but it's safer than having nuclear anywhere on your planet. Everything comes out of a chain reaction. It's not created by the sun. It's created by a chain reaction. Everything. They call it names that are similar because it has similar atomic numbers, similar makeup, but it's not the same element. We made it in a chain reaction that has its own atomic weight. And if it does match up to one in nature, it's still ionized and radiated atoms. Isotopes, rather, in the atom. See, that's the problem. That's why we have terrorist laws. That's why we have nuclear waste sites. That's why we have the puke machine out there talking about potassium-40 and 10,000 counts per minute in the human body. Don't worry about 10 from Fukushima. You already got 10,000 in your body. Yeah, that'll never change though. The minute I get one from Fukushima, I got 10,001. If I got 7,000 in a Becquerel, if I got 7,000 in a liter, if I got 7,000 in a liter, lucky for you, I don't have that imported yet. Tritium, 3H, which is man-made in the Canadian drinking water standards now. Now I got 10,700. Drink another liter, I got 10,000, 11,400. Drink another liter, I got 12,100. Now the numbers are going up because I'm consuming man-made. But if I just eat a banana every day, I stay the same. If I eat the normal food I eat every day without the contamination from Fukushima or man-made, the numbers will always be 10,000. But those 10,000 don't matter. You can't make a dirty bomb by blowing me up, you fucking morons. Idiots. Idiotic, stupid, moronic, potato chip peddlers walking in sunshine, getting on an airplane. These are fucking disgusting maggots. They got an education and know better. People that say that, you got to get in their fucking face. You got to call them out. That's your job. That's your obligation. You were made for it. Send me your address. I'll send you a certificate. You passed the nuclear proctologist banana peddler course. Send me another dollar and I'll tell you if you're gullible. 7,000 chemicals in a cigarette. I smoke one without 7,000 chemicals. Can't listen to Danny smoke cigarettes. Oh, let me come back to that one more time because I digressed all over the fucking place. Camera two. The precise contents of the smoke and vapor of reactor 3 and other reactors are as yet unknown. They're man-made ionizing radioactive material. They're well-known. They're well-studied. In fact, the man-made stuff is more studied than the natural stuff on this planet. Because there's more of it. And there's no money to study natural stuff unless you're trying to discover a new emitter to confuse people with. Like potassium 40, rubidium, radon, natural uranium. Is completely different than man in, you know, enriched uranium, where you took 400 train cars, doused it with incredible amounts of chemicals, and mixed that up with water to create even bigger mess to get a gram. And you need 5 million pounds in a reactor to run the fucking thing. Oh, it's green, clean, green, too cheap to fucking meter, Dana. You got 15,000 abandoned mines in Navajo. What planet are you from? Oh, Dana was swearing, I'm gonna run away now. Can't trust him, he's swearing. Can't trust him, he's not Christian enough. Can't trust him, he's not... He doesn't work at a university. Can't trust him. Blah, 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 blah. No radiation spike has been detected, so the common assumption is that all is fine. No, the common assumption is that the nuclear PR firms are out there in full fucking steam, lying, deceiving, manipulating, mass murdering everybody out there on the drop of a fucking hat. That's what that means. That means the nuclear industry and its apologists and its pundits and its magazines and just the blogs and... Like, think about... Alright, I didn't work it the way it was supposed to. If you couldn't see radiation, if you could see radiation, no matter where you're to... Or what you're looking at, you would just, like, if you're looking at each other, this is what you would see. If you were lucky, you could see it all, because there's so much of it coming out of these reactors, because they create such a friggin' volume. Like, that's the problem, isn't it? Hang on, I screwed that up, I wasn't paying attention. Dana Durnford, NuclearProctologist.org, at Livestream.com, and beautiful girl, boy, Dana on YouTube. Take a screen capture and email it to everybody you know. Take a screen capture and email it to every newspaper. Take a screen capture, put it up on Google or Bing or wherever, or Facebook, and then go ahead and link that to everybody and link, when you click on that picture, link it over to my site. We need a revolution of people sharing information because they can't control us all. They can control the few that is doing it, but they can't control us all if we all start doing it. So ultimately, that's what the way forward. Three full meltdowns, complete loss to four fools pools, and fool pools are used reactors. They're used reactors. They don't stop being reactors because you put them in a pool. And there was 9 million pounds in a common pool that they emit to. Now they claim there's nothing there, and that it was there was never nothing there. And we have the death of the Pacific Ocean. That's not a game. You go over to the nuclearproctologist.org, and you see that everything I'm saying to you is true. So Unit 3, I'm sorry, the tsunami in Japan killed people. The squares you're looking at, the bigger the square, corresponding red square with the red number is the, you know, the more people that died. And so the yellow numbers are people that are missing. Now that happened in the same spot, 400 miles of that coastline. Look at it again. Now 400 miles of the coastline, look where all the plants are too. Now 15 reactors in areas affected by the 311 quake. And that 14 reactors at four sites, different sites, not four reactor buildings, but four sites. But Fukushima governor strongly demands TEPCO decommission and dismantle. Wait, what's that? 10 nuclear reactors? Well, Fukushima only got six. That's the third one on your right-hand side from the top with six reactors. The Daini is only 10 miles away. Remember, Fukushima looked like that. Yeah? Yeah. Okay, and just a quick one. You had Norwegian Institute for Research, looking like that. You had the URAD project, looking like that. as the fallout over North America, folks. You got France, IRSN, fallout over North America, major, massive, incredible, unconceivable amount, not potassium 40, but incredible amounts of. The Norwegian Institute had to end it because they're under so much pressure from the Norwegian Institute. But just because they ended, does that mean the plume stopped? The plume stretched all the way across the Pacific Ocean, all the way across the continents. And so, therefore, think about it as a snowstorm that is right across the Pacific Ocean, the entire Pacific Ocean, the entire continent of North America at the one time is under an enormous snowstorm, even though you can't see it, hear it, smell it, taste it, feel it, pick it up, or throw rocks at it. Well, that's why 20 million particles of radioactive iodine. But that's a tracer. There's 10 times more 132, 30 times more 133, 31 more times 129 with a 15 million year ionizing radiating half-life. See, because it comes from a chain reaction. It's not like the stuff from nature, which is similarly named and similarly atomically numbered. Everything comes out of a chain reaction is a dirty bomb. So everything. There is nothing benign or innocuous coming from a chain reaction. See, absorbed radiation doses 132 is 10 times higher. It ionizes and radiates your thyroid glands 9 times more effectively. 133, there was 30 times more of that than 131. Same here in North America, same in every other Pacific Rim nation affected by it and this entire planet. Wherever iodine showed up, there was 31 times more, or 30 times more 133, and 31 times more 129. By March 21st, 5 nuclear isotopes were identified in Seattle. Everybody in Seattle was breathing 10 hot radioactive particles a day every day. Everybody was. Water from Fukushima reactor be released in the ocean after being purified. You can't purify the water. It can't be done. See? Average person in Seattle breathing 10 hot radioactive particles a day during April. Lethal threat from Fukushima highly radioactive water flown in the Pacific Ocean. This is April the 5th, 2013, being warned about it. Everybody makes fun of anybody that warns anybody about it. That's the nuclear industry. That's what makes them so disgusting. They're so cold-hearted and so emotionless. Is they just don't fucking care. They just don't care. They're soulless, spineless morons that know exactly what they're doing. They get a paycheck for doing it. Nuclear radiation is the most carcinogenic thing that exists on the entire fucking planet. And there was 1,500 atoms of the sulfur peroxide hydrogen buckyballs in the California air. So you're walking down the road, you're surrounded by a square meter air. Oops! 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 years down the road, that's a cancer. If you can hold your breath and run all the way home and hide away and you had perfect environment, you're still fucked. And cancers are the last ones to show up. There's 1,800 diseases. Alzheimer's, dementia, autism passed on to your children long before cancer will show up. Your diabetes will show up in mass. Leukemias will show up long before other cancers. It's because you got so much sequestered into your muscles or your bones from strontium and plutonium and americium, neptunium, because they act like calcium, right? And then they migrate into your bones to the same venues that the normal helpful stuff would go. Like normal calcium, like normally when you eat organic corn on the cob, you're getting 6,200 parts per million of calcium. And then you're getting 5,000 parts per million of potassium. It's good for you. Your body regulates it. You can't get any more in you than you need anyway, see? We're genetically superiorly selected because we're designed to live in harmony with natural stuff. So when anybody talks about natural, you want to haul a fucking big chunk of their hair out of their head. If they got an education, they know better. That's all I'm saying. You want to yell at them by doing that. That's how you do it to them. You make them haul their own chunks of hair out by yelling at them. All I'm saying. All right, don't send the police boy and arrest me again. Still got 2 court dates coming up. These guys will bankrupt the entire planet before they give an inch. Let's jump back in some of those headlines. U.S. West Coast bore a significant brunt of hot particles from Fukushima. Yeah, because the jet streams are real. I'm going to speed that up a bit here in a second. Ocean currents are real. This is the 17th of March. The 18th of March, boom! There's the Pacific coastline. By the 19th to 20th of March, everything that's hitting the mountains, not all of it, but the majority of it is washing back down through your lakes and rivers and estuaries and communities back down to the coastline. By the 22nd of March, this is only based upon a couple of days releases from a single reactor that was vented. It's not based upon the detonations. It's not based upon the meltdowns. It's not based upon the reactor cores of 5 million pounds in each core. Every 2 years, they put it up on the roof for 10 years. No. Same as this model. It's just based upon a couple of days releases from a single reactor. It's not based upon any real data. But anyway, all the isotopes were found, right? See, the iodine and the cesium are tracers. They're just tracers, moronic tracers. I don't care about them. Curium, I'm worried about the curium. But what they are, they're tracers, so they told me the curium showed up. They told me the plutonium showed up. They told me the uranium showed up. They told me the other 12,000 isotopes showed up, even though the majority of them are classified. It doesn't mean they don't exist. Just because I can't talk about them because I'm not able to find the literature on them. Does that mean they don't exist because it's classified? Because that's what people want you to believe. Health Canada alluding to 300 times background levels. You got any idea how much that actually is? Now you got to multiply that by iodine-129. They did. It was 220 million becquerels. They reported there last 3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago or so. 220 million. Becquerels of iodine-129 per liter of rainwater in British Columbia, Canada, shortly after Fukushima. That didn't stop coming out of there. The initial plume was big, sure, because millions and millions and millions and millions and millions and tens of millions of pounds had detonated. Around 300 million pounds is missing. 300 million. That's just 20-year cycle at Fukushima Prefecture. That's not counting the common... the other two reactors or the common spent fuel pools where they only claim there's 9 million pounds. Where did they put all this stuff to? Well, they did what every other nuclear plant does. They store it on site. And so when the tsunami came through, it took it out into the ocean. That's why they cemented the ocean floor in front of the reactors. Right? They spent a whole year after pouring cement on the ocean floor because all the fuel rods and everything got swept out right in front. California iodine-131, probably double or triple. Huh, I don't even care about the iodine, but the fact that that is so underreported meant there was so much more of the other thousands of radioactive isotopes that came through. Now, don't it? That rained out and continued to rain out. And that it was only one plume to hit the atmosphere, the upper and lower troposphere. It would take over a decade for a single plume to rain out, and not a big plume at that. See, a gram of it produces more atoms than every grain of sand on every beach on the planet. What the frig does 5 million pounds per reactor and 5 million pounds every 2 years in the fuel pool mean? I wonder. 300 times more radiation released in the atmosphere from burning debris than claimed by the government. Because the government only lies. It does nothing that you want it to do. It never done anything for you in your entire life. The structure was already put there before they showed up. And they had to maintain it because they don't want to be hitting potholes themselves. That's the only reason they fix anything, because they don't want to be dealing with it themselves. Is the government trying to contaminate every region in Japan by burning radioactive debris? They're burning it in the incinerators throughout the freaking country. 24 hours a day, 300,000 becquerels a kilogram. That's a dirty bomb. It's a fucking dirty bomb. It's okay for them to do it, but we got to lose all our rights because the terrorists might do it. Like the globe, the media and your universities are mentally fucking ill. They're the stupidest things imaginable. Like, because they got no conscience, they got no soul, they got no heart, but they got an education. And they got degree after degree after degree in how to present information as a public relation. Their whole career is based upon, they got a degree in one thing, but the rest of their accolades are for public relations. They got the job because they got all those accolades so they can handle the task given to them to cover up for corporations. They got corporate personhood and they need to cover up their misdeeds or their screw-ups because nobody can go to jail. So they got to cover up the damage is all they got to do. So thousands and thousands of the stupidest people on the planet, that's people who work at public relation firms. They're murderers. And they're soulless and spineless and heartless. They're emotionless. They're droids. They're dummies. They're human robots. In every sense of the word, they will kill you. Tell a robot to kill you, and the robot's not programmed properly, like a PR firm or a nuclear scientist or a pro-nuclear or 350.org or James Hansen or James Colbert or University of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada, or the judge who said I couldn't use bananas and say that that's wrong, it's homeostasis. No, dude, science is settled. My last court appearance. The media demonizes me throughout the country, accuses me of death threat I'm charged with, criminal harassment and nuclear pukes that deserve it, and that I'm not going to be giving it up anytime soon or in my entire life. Put me in jail for all I care. This planet will wake up a lot quicker. That's how I see it. You're doing me a favor and the planet a favor. I'm not saying I want to go to jail. I'm just saying you're doing the planet a favor. Fukushima will start burning radioactive waste 100,000 becquerels. We're almost through it. And five pets die in one household. Five pets in a couple of hours. No, it's fine, Dana. It's like a banana. It's like potassium 40, Dana. Everybody got it in them, Dana. A little bit more is not going to hurt, Dana. I break a piece of fucking rebar on your head, it might hurt a bit. It is abnormal for sure. Yeah, they're burning it in the incinerators, right? Japan gonna burn plutonium. They got the incinerators right at the Fukushima power plant, 24 hours a day, and guess what they're doing? They're burning that shit, aren't they? What do you think, they're only gonna burn building material and clothing at Fukushima Prefecture? Are you that fucking gullible? 170 microsievers. Give us becquerels, morons. 14 prefectures in Japan due to Fukushima radionuclides. That's 2013. Remember, Hillary Clinton, what Hillary Clinton done to you? She signed an agreement they weren't going to check the food for the first couple of years, didn't she? No, Dana, that's fine. Dana, look at it. I think you should just fire it back up, Dana. Okay, that's all we got today. I'm starting to get pissy, a little angry. That's not cool, or maybe it is. It's just human nature. How can I not get upset? How can I not be indignant? How can you not be indignant that they told you it was like a banana and a potato chip and walking in the sunshine? For how long? For how many years? Because it's like a banana? No. And then you go to another radio station where worried terrorists might get their hands on some of it. Get back on another radio station. I don't know what everybody's concerned about. They had a little leak there, but it's like a banana. It's completely harmless. It's not going to hurt the environment or anybody else. Next morning, you see them on another radio station. Yeah, rumors is terrorists were planning on breaking in a nuclear power plant. We got to beef up security at them all. It's going to cost hundreds of billions of dollars, but we got to do it. We got a lot of stuff there. We got nowhere to put it. Get on another radio station the next day. Yeah, hi, kids. Nuclear is green, clean, and too cheap to meter. You get your mommy and daddy and report them if they're using gas and wasting it. Boom! I fucking hate everything about all you people. You are the most maniacal, twisted, manipulative creatures on the planet. You do nothing for society, only lie. Your entire industry, the nuclear industry, is predicated upon bananas and potato chips and walking in sunshine. Fucking fantasy in all your media and all your movies and all your Hollywood and all your blogs, like mainstream blogs that are carried by mainstream, this is the rhetoric you cannot escape. They won't give it up for a second. You'll never have another narrative there saying, hey, wait a second. Why did you say terrorists are going to get it and then tell the other crew it's like a banana? Why did you do that? Bang. Someday somebody's going to do that. Somebody's just going to freak out and say, I can't lie no more. And smash their microphone on the desk and get up and say, like, quit. It's a lie. It's a big fabrication. I can't lie anymore. I just had to take my last child down for her last chemotherapy, and she died. And I got to get her, or they'll fire me this morning. Because they're heartless, they're soulless. Because that's the nuclear industry. That's the nuclear industry. Your children, your friends, and your loved ones going to a hospital, and they don't come out because they squirt them with man-made ionizing radioactive chemicals called chemotherapy. And they signed a waiver saying you can stick up their arse, kill them, you still can't sue them. Before they'll give you that chemotherapy, because it'll kill. Only 2% of the people getting chemotherapy survive any longer. Why the fuck is your universities, why the hell are your institutions, why the fuck are everybody taking their children there and doing it? Because the government is captured and it'll go take your child and go kill them if you don't let the doctors do it. Hugs for everybody. Elaine says her Geiger counter goes higher when she puts it down by her foot. It's crazy, eh? And that's madness. Bruce, Kay, Ellie, Albert, Candace, Shanikin, Alex Bershaw, Kay, Paul, White Sparrow, hugs for everybody. I don't get everybody, I know. I try Amthurst is out there somewhere. And everybody else, Jan Brooks is out there. Always working hard. So is everybody else. Kevin Blanche never stops. Thomas Ackerman. And I'll put a higher quality up at A Beautiful Girl by Dana when the stream is over. I didn't bring everybody up to say goodbye to him. I'm over there scrolling away, looking at the camera. There it goes. We're gone. Just like that. Hugs for everybody. It was a good stream today. I kind of freaked out a few times. And by the way, anybody, we still ain't raising any money this week. And that's okay. And it takes time for money to transfer on top of that. I know that. I have to raise money all the time for the next number of years to get the equipment and to do the things we got to do and to keep pushing back the way we're pushing back. Donate anything or anything is fine, see? And if enough people do it, I won't have to ask no more. Donate at PayPal. You'll find links under my Beautiful Girl by Dana on YouTube channel, and also for the Fukushima Hounds for Kate. Kate needs help. She's never asked for anything, but I'm going to start pushing her out there and get her so much deserved help. She's been volunteering with that website, and that helped us dramatically accomplish our goal of the Fukushima Expeditions for Life along the British Columbia coastline that shows an extinction event playing out. We say hugs for everybody. We'll see everybody on Monday. I don't know, I'm probably going to sleep all weekend again. I'm probably not going to get out on the boat. I'm burnt out. I will try though, hopefully. We got to get more documentation. We'll do a bird count. We'll see everybody on the rebound. Take care. Hugs, everybody. We'll see you soon. April the 1st, 2016. And Japan has just announced that they're going to donate $50 million to the Nuclear Proctologist Defense Fund against Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution and the University of Victoria, British Columbia, Canada. $50 million. So they just gave me $50 million bucks. I was too busy screaming. That's why I'm late this morning. What are we going to do with all that money? $50 million from Japan to fight the nuclear apologist here in Canada and Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution. Oh, by the way, did I mention it was April Fool's morning? No, I probably didn't mention it before I said that, did I? A lot of people are now going, Data, how could you? How could you? I don't know. It just came right out of my mouth. It was just like that. Here it was. Oops. Everybody's clicking away now. Everybody's like, screw you, Dana. Damn it. Morning, everybody. Let's come on and say hi to everybody. We had a tough morning. I've been at this for hours trying to get this thing to stream. And I was making a simple mistake when I deleted the other one because of the problems. This morning I was trying to import cancer, and one of the headlines, a screen capture of a headline I got, has a virus in it. That's from a couple of years ago. Brutal. I don't know if I got it, but anyway, I screwed my computer. And so yesterday was a nightmare. Good morning, Bruce. Good morning, Nash. Hi, Kay. I see Kate is in there. Good morning, Kate. And she was booted off all day yesterday on the stream. Kate got the Fukushima hounds. And on my... Kate got Fukushima hounds, and on my... Hang on a second. Kay got Fukushima hounds, and you can find her at my YouTube channel under my videos, a link to her. And then you'll find... Let me see. Done deal. And so you can donate to Kate. There's a link directly to her PayPal where you donate. Click on that link below my videos on YouTube, and it'll take you right to her account, so you can donate directly into her PayPal account. It's a good thing to do. She's been at this a long time. She's never asked anything of anybody. And I know yesterday people did help her out. And I know she's ecstatic that she got any help at all. Not that she's asking for it. I'm asking for it. And that was well received yesterday. And I can't thank people enough. I really can't for what they've done. For just starting that motion and making it real. And I know there's so many people out there working hard, and I don't mention them, and I don't try to help them, because I'm not able to keep up with it myself. I'm just not able to do the things I want to do on top of that. But I got to learn to help people out. Morning, Chris. Good morning, everybody. Nash just got himself banned. If he was joking, well, that was a big mistake. Don't joke on my site. Get your ass banded. Let's get on to show. Maybe we got a show today. Who knows? Japan, because it takes us 5 minutes to get up to speed. Japan, and like, you got to realize how much agony I've went through in the last 4 or 5 days trying to make this happen. We had all kinds of issues. I finally got them just solved a few minutes ago, I'm pretty sure. We're streaming, so... The tsunami came through the country. Well, first off, the Japanese earthquake, that traveled at 9,000 miles per hour. 9,000 miles per hour. So it hit Florida in about a half an hour. It shook the country for 6 minutes, like a wet blanket, in the wind. The blanket still wiggles. Yeah. Not like a dry blanket where it flops completely around, even though that is what happened. You know, like a 9.0 earthquake is producing 1 to 3 G ground forces. That means at 1 G you can't even stay on your feet. So it rocked that country for 6 minutes. It was 7,000 times worse than Christchurch, 1,000 times worse than Haiti. These were devastating earthquakes, but just to give you some context. And then tsunamis, 400 miles of the coastline. The tsunami came in, and this is roughly an area where it killed people. And the red numbers you see, the squares, the bigger the square, the more people died, if you can't read the numbers. And the numbers are very high numbers in red, are the people that died. And then the yellow numbers are the people that are missing. So look at that. Now, here's Fukushima, is the fourth one on your top right-hand side down. You'll see six power plants, six... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm sorry, the third one down. The next one is Daini. That one was destroyed also. We're going to cover a lot of that. There was 15 reactors along that coastline were destroyed. I'm going to show you the meltdowns at Japan that are confirmed. This is Unit 1. This is Unit 2. These are 100% meltdown, melt-through, melt-outs. This is Unit 3. And this is Unit 4. Now, Unit 4, they tore it all down, and then they showed you pictures of a beautiful pool on the interior. And so they brought in this truck because the building looks like this and like that, not like this, not like that. Is that very hard for anybody to wrap their mind around? Okay. Where's all the other fun stuff I got through? So you got four meltdowns, melt-throughs, and melt-outs. The country was washed away in a wood chipper, and it killed those people on that coastline. Now, it also, those four buildings I just showed you produced over 30 million, not 10 million like media is reporting. 30 million bags confirmed. 30 million one-ton bags. You could wrap the planet five times in one-ton trucks. If you put a one-ton bag in each truck, because that's what a one-ton truck will hold. And so these buildings were destroyed. Just four of them, right? And so unit 1, 2, 3, and 4. Number four was the one that came out and I just showed you that deceived you about. It lost everything. So when they said, if number four goes, bye-bye Japan, and you have to evacuate North America. Well, guess what? Bye-bye Japan, and we got to evacuate North America. Oh, I see what's going on there. Yeah, I see what's going on there. Hang on a second. I'll come in and fix that real quick here. Because I had that set up for the guitar, right? And then I'm supposed to come in and set everything back to normal before I show any kind of pictures in the background or anything. So we'll come back over. Now the pictures look pretty again. See, it looks a lot better now, don't it? So that's unit 4. In the background, that's four reactors we're talking about. If I come back over here, 30 million bags. Now that's what they clean up around the country, okay? 30 million bags clean up around the country. Now that's, these bags are only meant to last a year. They're highly radioactive. That's just from the fallout from the four buildings, right? That's the fallout. You know, just because they showed you these are the official pictures. That's the official inside picture of the official outside picture. That's the official inside picture of the official outside picture of number four. Does that make any sense to anybody? But 30 million bags. See, this is why we say the radiation has killed the Pacific, because 30 million bags is nothing that they cleaned up from four lousy buildings. That not right there at the site, but all over the country. Not even all over the country, all over Fukushima Prefecture. So they brought in these big trucks for that pool there, because that's what they showed you, but it actually looks like this. But actually there's no pool there because the pool was up high on the roof. And so all these people died along the coastline because of the tsunami. Not from the earthquake, but from the tsunami. And the power plant is right there. You got 15 reactors in that area. Think about Chernobyl. Was only one reactor. It was one third the size of any of the reactors in Japan. And Chernobyl was a 30% meltdown. Chernobyl stopped after 10 days. Fukushima didn't stop, see? But 14 reactors at four sites were affected on 3/11. And here's an interesting one where the governor strongly demanded TEPCO decommission and dismantle all 10 reactors. He wanted all 10 reactors from Fukushima and Daiichi because the tsunami ran through that place. They had no power. The day melted down. That's why there's 30 million bags. They just didn't bother telling you about that. But see, that's why there's 30 million bags, because there was multiple reactors throughout the country. So Dainey, so extreme situation, though not much has been broadcast. An extreme situation, though not much has been broadcast. Okay. Are you gullible? Are you going to believe them, or are you going to believe 15 other plants were shut down due to damage? Are you going to believe all these headlines, or are you just going to believe the PR firms, the nuclear public relation firms, that are thugs? They come at you, look like very cute, but turn your back on them, and it's spider farms everywhere. Cooling system. So many, many reactors. Like, look at the reactors, boiling 1 million gallons a minute. That's why they got these big stacks. And you see why those steam, that steam is traveling so high? It's not traveling that height. Like, think of a house fire. Does a house fire look like that? Does, you know, when you're burning campfire, does the smoke go straight up and you can sit up close to the fire, or does the smoke just come right around you all the time? You know how it lingers, smoke, forest fire 10 miles away, and you can look outdoors and you can't see across the street. But look at this stuff, it's going up hot because it's so hot, right? They're boiling water to produce electricity, but each glass of water has a billion creatures in it, and each reactor is going through a million gallons a minute, 24 hours a day, 1,440 minutes a day. So 1,440 minutes a day, this thing is killing, every minute, each reactor, there's 440 reactors out there, and each reactor is boiling 16 million times a billion creatures per minute. Clean, green, carbon free, right? How is that possible when it's destroying six? Dude, get out your calculators, get them out, and do 1 million gallons divided by glasses of water, and a glass of water has a billion creatures. And 75 to 100 million of those creatures in each glass, and 16 million glasses a minute, and 440 reactors. Get out your calculators and do your numbers. I'm not talking to the people that understand what I'm talking about. I'm talking to the pro-nuclear crowd that won't listen to another narrative and come here to mock me and ridicule me and attack me and demonize me and vilify me and marginalize me like they've been doing since I started. None of them will get a marine biologist and go look at the pictures I got up at the nuclear proctologist. How interesting is that? How interesting that I come ashore after 15,000 miles, 260 days on the ocean, 2,000 pictures average a day for most days of the coastline with GPS documentation showing an extinction event. And 4.2 million other species didn't recede the coastline. No one bothers to mention that. No marine biologist comes out and supports me. And then the 2,000 nuclear PR firms don't have many targets, are attacking me on every blog and every website and every venue on the planet. And then I was arrested when I came ashore before I can produce the documentary, and then destroyed and vilified and bankrupted. And then the internet had to support me. The internet had to rally, and the internet did. It produced 60 articles after I was demonized in the media across Canada and came out and eviscerated the alleged victims. There are PR firms from Woods Hole. These are nuclear puke machines, nuclear mass murderers. These people are responsible for millions and millions of cancers by telling people to go ahead and eat the product from the Pacific Ocean. I went out and documented the coastline. They went out into the deep sea, took samples, and said they didn't find any tracers. They didn't even look for the other 12,000 man-made radioactive isotopes. 10,000 of them are classified. There's actually, if I remember correctly, there's around 5,500 declassified. We know there's over 10,000 classified. No one knows what India or Pakistan or Canada or America or anybody else is really producing, or Israel, or these stupid, idiotic, moronic, mass murdering a handful of corporations and the people that work for them. You know, like, think of a nuclear scientist, got an education. He knows that potassium 40 got nothing to do with something that comes out of a reactor. That's why we have terrorist laws. That's why we have nuclear waste sites. I'm so happy. I'm just going to stop right there for a second. I'm so friggin' happy that I'm streaming today. I'm so grateful that I'm streaming. You can't imagine it. The misery that I've gone through in the last couple of days trying to get the kinks out of this. I think I conquered it about 3 minutes before I got the stream ready to start. I had to cancel the last stream about a half an hour ago. Like, what I do in the background, you can't imagine. I know I say that to people, and I shouldn't say it. I don't think it matters how hard I work all day, every day, relentlessly for years, or the fact that I covered 9,000 headlines before I went on the ocean and done any of the expeditions for life. Fukushima, Japanese ambassador. No single weapon competes with the potential damage from Fukushima Unit 4. No? Okay, hang on. So what he's talking about, I don't want to lose my spot here, that's all. Okay, I'll find that again. So he's saying no single weapon competes with the potential damage if Unit 4 has... It blows up. This is the official picture they showed you when he was talking about it. But here's what it actually looked like. See? This is what it looked like. This is what they come out and showed you. Do you friggin' get it yet? Do you understand what they've done to you? Hang on. Like, I want you to think about this tsunami, the detonation. This is what we focus on, but think about the tsunami. Think about the tsunami. Look at the carnage that it wrecks upon the country. It went up to 10 kilometers inshore, and like the charts I showed you before, around 400 kilometers of the coastline. Some of these pictures are not the best pictures, but that's what we got. We're lucky to have them. So here it comes. This took out 400 kilometers of the coastline. You know, I can't even imagine what goes through that person's mind as he stood there looking at his former world, at his former universe, at his former paradigm that he grew up and he was compartmentalized, say. I'm not saying he is, I'm just saying if he was one of those people that grew up and had a very comfortable life and lived there all their life. So you got all that, you know, your whole life a really good time, and then you just have one bad day. And that bad day never goes away. And it carries away your families and your friends and your loved ones and everybody around you, but you have to carry on. Look at these containers. These are transport truck containers. But look at the debris. This is out in the ocean. There's a debris field in the ocean 2,000 miles long. This was unimaginable. This ran through the country, and how many telephone poles do you see standing in that neighborhood? How many power pole lines do you see there? How many telephone poles with power sources you can reconnect power do you see here? At 400 kilometers of the coastline where you swept away the entire villages and the communities and everything else. Where do you see the infrastructure? Here. Do you got any idea how long it took to put that road there? Through that carnage, through that incredible, unbelievable, unimaginable, nightmarish, catastrophic. There's nothing to compare it to. I have nothing in my life I can compare to that moment, to that day, to that week, to that future. I have nothing I can compare that to. I have nothing I can draw upon in real life to say that I suffered like them people suffer. That I understand what they're going through. That I can't envision. I can in some ways that particular picture a little ways, because I spend all my life on the ocean. And I understand the sheer terror that they could possibly go. I can't understand their exact emotions, but I can imagine the absolute unimaginable, surrounded by this raging storm and carnage all around you. And so when you look around you, today, tomorrow, and the next day, you don't see that. You're not living that. You're not walking through that. You're not hoping and praying over that. You're not able to conceive that. You're not able to understand that, and neither am I. A picture doesn't do it justice. A picture doesn't drive the point home. A picture is not capable of it. What's going through their mind, if you were able to broadcast that out for 30 seconds, would shatter you, would leave you... would leave you with, it would make you humble that you have running water and that you have electricity and that you are able to smile or that you are able to feel joy. they can't. When something like that comes to your country, it is worse than anything imaginable. But then to have nuclear on top of that is just, is too much to bear. And the country has snapped under such enormous misery and agony and heartbreak. And that's why they're hiding it, because they can't carry on with just what they got to deal with every day, let alone carry on with the radiation on top of that. And so they blocked that out. And a lot of people done it for money in Japan, in the government. But a lot of them were so, I don't know if post-traumatic stress describes it in any kind of shape or form, but that's one of the few things I can withdraw upon to try to give you some context without conjectures. But it's just a conjecture because we're not there. And so where's the telephone poles? There's one right there on the ground, I think. So 300,000 plus becquerels a square meter. A square meter is where your child stands up with an umbrella over their head. It only included iodine-131. There's 10 times more iodine-132, 30 times more iodine-133, 31 times more iodine-133, and 31 times more iodine-129. It's coming up, I'll show you that in a little tiny bit. And then that's just a tracer iodine. So if there's 300,000 becquerels, then you got to multiply that by 31 for the 129 with a 15 million year half-life. Multiplied by 30 for the 133 with a 5-day half-life times 10. A half day is times 10. A half-life is times 10. But the reality of it was is that all the other rates, these are tracers. So that meant everything else was there. The americium, neptunium, the plutoniums, the uraniums, the strontiums, all the cesiums, and on a matter of quantities. And curium is the biggest product coming out of the fuel plant. Not iodine, not cesium. It's curium. And which is a fissionable product, and it's produced after the chain reaction in such an abundance. It's well known, but they kept it away from you. That's why you, if you go back and look through history, all you hear is iodine and curium for 98% of the articles you're going to read. Inhaling just one radioactive hot particle can and will cause cancer, but cancer takes 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 years to manifest, show up, get diagnosed. And there's 1,800 diseases will show up beforehand. Let me come back over here for a second. And hi, Zoe. Zoe joined the frame. Hi, Zoe, you okay? Yeah, big smiles. She always gives you these big smiles when she... I'm having a cigarette. Anybody's offended? Please feel free to jump out a window. Put it on YouTube so I can enjoy it. Okay, I made that part up. My cigarettes do not have 7,000 chemicals, but your friends and loved ones and families and anybody else that you know that smoke most likely do. And so it's not nicotine that gives you cancer, it's the 7,000 chemicals. And because I've been under so much stress the last couple of days, I've smoked a couple of cigarettes without the chemicals. I'm not a bad person for smoking a cigarette without a chemical. And just, I want to put that out there so people know there's cigarettes out there with their chemicals. This is all. A little rough putting it out there that way, Dana, but a single hot particle. And everything from the reactors are hot particles. Everything. Particularly from Japan. Particularly from a meltdown. Particularly from detonations. Former Department of Energy official criticized this. A Berkeley professor for comparing ingestion of radioactive iodine to air travel. Yeah, and he's criticized them because a banana, like a banana got nothing to do, the potassium 40 is homeostasis, your body regulates it, you can't get any more in your body than you have naturally. And everything has potassium 40 in it. And everything treats it as homeostasis. If you try to add potassium 40 to anything, there's only so much you can put it there that's already there. It won't accept it. Off gases it, for lack of better explanation. But it can't hold anymore. But man-made, you can keep piling it on. It'll keep accumulating it. It'll keep sequestering. I'll kill that just because the smoke is in the screen. I got two doors open and the window open. And I don't got 7,000 chemicals. Don't have a seizure. Don't go in the corner and defecate on yourself. Because you seen Dana with a cigarette. People inhale up to 85,000 becquerels of radioactivity in just 4 hours. Once again, for a Berkeley professor comparing it, this is what all professors at every university is going to do if asked to speak publicly, if asked to be on the record, if asked to be candid. That's why they got the job, is because they're puke machines. That's a puke machine. Anybody says like it's on an airplane is the same thing as smacking you in the mouth and telling you to shut your mouth. That's exactly what they've done to you. That's exactly what they're doing to you. That's exactly why they've done it to you. They smacked you in the mouth as hard as they could, told you to get lost, told you to shut your pie hole. It's like a banana. Get lost. Like getting on an airplane. Shut up. You're too stupid to know. That's what they're saying to you. That's what a nuclear scientist is saying to you. That's what a nuclear pro blog is saying to you. All nuclear pro blogs do it. Every one of them out there. Atomic Insight, Nuclear Notes, Jane Conqueror from Forbes. Every one of them out there. Every one of them out there does it to you. And that's what they're doing to you. They're calling you an idiot. They're making fun of you. They're ridiculing you. They're calling you a moron. They're calling you a useless piece of shit. They're telling you to shut your fucking mouth. Shut your pie hole. That's what they're saying to you when they say it to you. When they say it's like a banana, say it's like a potato chip, you're at a lecture, they just told you to shut your fucking mouth. They just call you an idiot. Yeah, that's a fact. That's what they've done to you. They call you an idiot. They call you a moron, call you an asshole. That's what they're doing. It's no different. You don't understand it. Now you do. When someone tells you that, you should tell them to fuck off. When someone tells you like a banana, your instant reply should be, go fuck yourself. Go fuck off, you moron. Don't say it low. Say it nice and loud so everybody can hear it. Say, banana got nothing to do with a chain reaction. I'm not listening to another word from you. Get up. Walk out. You should go to their lectures just so you can do that. Say, hey, banana got nothing to do with a chain reaction. I'm leaving. That's all you got to do. You don't, that's not illegal. That's not an act of defiance. That's just saying, hey, I came here to hear the story. If you're going to lie, I'm not sitting here. I want my money back. I want my money back, and I want it right now. You go to their lectures, you say, I want my money back. The minute they say it's like a banana, potato chip, getting on an airplane, sleeping the next somebody, or anything like that. Anything to do with natural, stupid. I'm going to start yelling. Everyday, normal, indigenous radiation. There's only 160 of them. We got thousands of man-made ones. They're ionizing their radiation. There's 6 times more breast cancer if you live around a nuclear power plant. 20 times more leukemia for children if you live around a nuclear power plant. 20% more, rather. That we know about. A lot of kids move away. Every 3 or 4 years, their families are moving. Who knows what the real numbers are? They build them in big cities because there's so many transient people. Why not build them 50 miles away? Oh, you can pump the power 1,000 miles down the coast, but you can't build a nuclear power plant away from the city for some reason. You got to take up all that real estate right there. Clean, green, too cheap meter. Boom! Anybody says that to me, I don't give a fuck about you. I'm so tired of that lie. I'm so sick of it. 70 years. We covered 9,000 headlines before we went on the ocean for 260 days, up to 5 months without coming home. 15,000 miles. That's up at the nuclear proctologist. I show it almost every day. The whole coastline's missing. The 4 million other species don't come in. I'm demonized and vilified and attacked constantly, relentlessly, endlessly, ridiculed, mocked, humiliated, because I say that the things I say. I back it up with the documentation. There's nobody else on the planet does it. I'm it. Everybody else coward, too afraid to go out, too afraid to tell the truth. you know, how hard would it be to deal with an issue if we didn't have everyone lying to us? We didn't have all the media and all the institutions saying it's like a banana. Unless the terrorists get it, then it's a dirty bomb. 85,000 becquerels, and that's only iodine. Once again, they're punching you in the mouth. They're kicking you in the face. They're stepping on your life. They're destroying your friends and your families and your loved ones because they say they only talk about iodine. They only talk about, you know what I'm saying? They, like the people who done the study, they talk about iodine. Because the academics know that when you see iodine, everything else is there because that's a tracer. 40% of the Fukushima visitors show an internal exposure to radiation. The walls are 40%. June 2nd, 2011. March, April, May, June. 40%. Internal. And every one of them, they're dead people walking. Dead women, dead children, dead men walking. It takes 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30 years for the cancer to manifest. They get diagnosed. But diabetes is rampant down there because that's one of the manifestations of radiation illnesses. And besides Alzheimer's and dementia and heart, liver, lung, respiratory, breast cancers will show up fairly quick. Leukemia will show up right away because it's sequestered into your bones. You're producing mutated stem cells. Japan Times, the walls are cracked below the ground of Fukushima reactor building as if the damage above ground isn't enough to worry about. And it was. It was completely wrecked there. Military unit was severely contaminated when number three exploded. Exploded! It, well, finally somebody admitted it. Media will show you building one and two, but won't show you three and four. And if you do show you four, they'll show you a beautiful interior. You live in? You got to hold the people accountable or they won't stop lying. Two of the guys were so radioactive they couldn't stand next to each other. No one got hurt, Dana. It's like bananas, Dana. Boom. Hey, what are you doing on your back? Mystery black substance has 1 million plus becquerels a kilogram of cesium. Cesium's just a tracer. It's just a tracer. A tracer. Cesium, iodine. What about the thousands of other radioactive isotopes? Why not tell everybody it's just a tracer? Why not do at least that much? Go look at all the studies on radiation and they'll call it a tracer. But you go into the media and they'll say, oh, there's iodine there. The scientists are worried. What? What's his name? Stop fucking doing that. Scientists are worried. What's his name? What's her name? We don't care. I don't care what institution it is. What is the name of the scientist, or your article is garbage, or your media broadcast is garbage? What is their name when you do that? Scientists say it's like eating a banana. Sometimes you'll roll them out. Like John Neal from Oklahoma University. Oklahoma, they make dirty bombs at McAllister with an A, bomb manufacturer in McAllister, Oklahoma. All they make is dirty bombs. The A-10 Warthog, all it shoots is dirty bombs. Everything on it is a dirty bomb. And it shoots a ton and a half a minute. That's the Anamasa equivalent of 44,000 Nagasaki bombs worth of radiation be released into the environment. That depleted uranium, Dolram, it used to be called Dolram. No one knows how they got rid of the acronym on it, but they call it DU now. But Dolram, depleted uranium, low-level radioactive material, that's a dirty bomb. Terrorists get it, dirty bomb. You take it, explode it in some community, dirty bomb, you go to jail for life, vilified forever, documentaries, movies, all kinds of books. He was a terrorist. He took the depleted uranium, blew it up in our fuel pool, put it in our swimming pool, put it in our drinking water. But we fired 5.5 million rounds a month of munitions, and the majority of that was dirty bombs from McAllister's bomb manufacturer in McAllister, Oklahoma. Dirty bombs is all they're making. That's all the A-10 Warthog shoots is dirty bombs. That's why they fly low. Only takes one bullet to kill a tank. What? You can't kill a tank with the other bombs you got? Like you haven't got enough bombs? They were using, they make bullets for rifles that are uranium. 5.5 million rounds a month to get 10,000 bad guys. Don't bother calling them Taliban or Mujahideen. Shut up, morons. They're just people. They bleed. If they shoot them, they fall down just the same as you shot me. No different. They're not Superman. They're not. They're illiterates, for Christ's sakes. They're not even educated. You know, they got rifles. And you come after them with tanks and satellites and drones and jets and helicopters. There's just incredible amounts of munition on it. And you shoot up the entire country because there's three of them in there somewhere. In Syria, you wrecked the entire country, 7 million refugees, and you wrecked every building in the country. Every building in the country. And you started Syria war a couple of days after Fukushima. Soon as Syria war ended, boom! You had detonations in Belgium. Right? In Brussels. Now the war on terrorism in second gear again. You got to go to war against somebody else. Because you destroyed, there's nothing to bomb left in Syria. And then you imported them all over the world. Something you've never done before. Ever. Israel got 5 million Palestinian refugees, for Christ's sakes. They control non-stop, but they can't control the 1.7 million and they can. They just can't control the 10,000 Hamas. I mean, 10,000 Taliban. You wrecked 28 million in Afghanistan, left 6 million orphans. Millions dead, millions missing, millions refugee camps. Millions unaccounted for. All of them without homes, all of them starving to death, all of them without IDs, all of them without patents, all of them without pensions. You've done the same thing in Iraq, you've done the same thing in Libya, same thing in Syria to get 10,000 bad guys. You're fucking morons. You're morons. You're idiots. You bought into that because the media sold it to you, but you're idiots for not asking questions, for not looking yourself, for sitting there, we gotta get them. They bombed us. We gotta go wreck that entire country. Yeah, 5 million orphans is a pretty fair price to pay to get 10,000 guys. So by proxy, if we had 10,000 Taliban showed up in Canada, then we can wreck every building, every street, every telephone pole, every infrastructure in Canada to get those 10,000 bad guys. Because they might kill a few people, chop a few heads off. And they were created and funded by the CIA and the FBI and the rogue elements in our government. They're out of control. They're out of control. Let's keep going on the headlines. But they're out of control. You people are out of control. No, I support the war on terror, didn't it? Millions dead, millions missing to get 10,000 bad guys. They're morons. I'm not saying to the people who's watching the video. I'm just talking to the puke machines out there. Nearly 5,000 nuclear plant workers suffering. Suffering. Look at the word suffering. Suffering. Internal radiation exposure after visiting Fukushima. Internal radiation exposure after eating Fukushima. There we go. Keep going. Over 1,000 nuclear workers have internal radiation counts of 10,000 counts per minute. That's not potassium 40, okay? You remember the headline earlier? One atom? They got 10,000. One atom will cause cancers. They got 10,000. People got no heart. People got no soul in the nuclear industry. They don't care. Most don't know, but reactor one melted down in 5 hours. How can you almost lose one third of the nation due to four buildings? How do you lose one third of the nation due to four buildings? How do you get 30 million one-ton bags from four buildings? Same way you kill the Pacific Ocean with four buildings. It's the same way you almost lost. You did lose one third of the nation. Everything north of Tokyo is highly contaminated. Everything. Everything north of Tokyo is blocked in most countries for food imports. Average person in Seattle breathed in 10 radioactive hot particles a day. I'm gonna play a clip for you coming up from Japan. He's going to go and set the video at the same time. I'll get the volume up in one
second. Computer simulation shows how radioactivity spread around the world from the disabled Fukushima Daiichi plant. The simulation was created by a group of researchers at the University of Tokyo and Kyushu University and released on Wednesday. The simulation is based on the scenario in which contaminated air was vented from the disabled number 2 reactor building on March 14th, 3 days after the massive earthquake and tsunami. Computer images show the radioactive material was lifted 5,000 meters into the air. It was then carried by westerly winds and spread over the Pacific Ocean. The images indicate that on the fourth day after being vented, the substances reached the west coast of the United States, and on the seventh day, they approached Iceland after crossing the Atlantic. The radiation was down to 1/1,000,000,000th level compared to when it was emitted on March 14th.
影響という観点から言えばですね、非常に小さかった、非常に限定的だった、特にそのアジアへの影響はですね、ほとんどないというふうに考えます。
So, 1 billion to the level it was originally. And so you only need one plume coming out of there, but that model is only based upon releases from a single reactor, right? Australian forecast map shows possible radioactivity east of Los Angeles by March the 18th. This was 4 days after Australia had put out a forecast of the releases that were announced, that they vented. Not the detonated buildings like I showed you earlier, not the meltdowns, not the spent fuel pools, not the 15 reactors that were in distress and destroyed and damaged, and 10 of them should be torn down by the governor like I've shown you earlier. Latest forecast is all California. That's the Norwegian Institute for Air Research. Once again, here's another one, right? 137 is just a tracer, but it was high altitude radiation cloud concentrating. This is only based upon a couple of days' releases, not based upon the ongoing constant releases, the detonations, the meltdowns, the spent fuel pools full of reactor cores. No. But here's a model based upon what they emitted to originally. This was the IRSN, France's Institute, and this was National Norwegian Institute for Air Research saying they're going to end public forecasts and they're just going to give it to the big corporations only because they look like that. Here's Canada, went out and flew along the coastline. Canada said several studies on the radioactive, this is March the 18th, there was already several studies, we've never seen them, from Fukushima nuclear power plant already exist. Really? By the 18th, Canada had several. It said the Fukushima plume provided a nice opportunity. Whoever wrote that should be shot and hung at the same time. To test radioactivity detection capability. Provided a nice opportunity. Like, these are the words of mental illnesses. That's the words of somebody that got a real severe mental illness. My cigarettes don't got 7,000 chemicals. Oh, cigarettes, nicotine causes cancer, Dana, not 7,000 chemicals. Who's going to say that to me, eh? Who's the moron out there going to utter those words? We got a little blurp blurp there. Hang on. Blurp blurp. I'll fix it. That was supposed to be fixed. I fixed it. So here's British Columbia, Canada, flying over the country. Vancouver Island, every 15 minutes they're taking a sample. Every 15 minutes, what you're seeing there is the samples they were taking, right? Every 15 minutes, they took a sample, and then they produced a model. They hid that away for a couple of years. We never seen that for a couple of years, right? Look at the model. There's another model based upon just a couple of days' releases that was vented, not from the detonations, not from the fires, not from the explosions. None of these are. It's because a grant can produce 88 times 37 billion of man-made stuff, whereas natural is 0.0005071, 71 10 millionths of 37 billion. I know that's confusing. Should be anyway. Not supposed to be, but they make it confusing, see? And this stuff has half-lives of billions of years. Well, I'm sorry, hundreds of thousands of years, as if that mattered. Look at the models, all kinds of models. These are all based up on the first week or 2 weeks showed up, based up on 2 days of venting, not based up on the detonations, not based up on the massive fires, not based up on the carnage along the coastline, all the other reactors, not based up on the spent fuel pools that were on the roof of each of the buildings that are missing on a couple of buildings and are known to be missing in the other two. How many models do you need to see anyway? This is NOAA, but this is not based up on real projections. This is just based up on jack shit compared to what actually came out. These models are not even based up on the amount that came out of Chernobyl. These models are based up on just a venting from a single reactor. They've never produced a model of the actual meltdowns. Keep going. Running out of time. Here's another model. By the way, the ocean currents are real. I know that's going to come as a shock to some people. And that's why this one exists. This is only based upon a couple of days' releases of a couple of isotopes. Same as all the other models. They're not based upon the actual meltdown, melt-through, melt-outs. Yet the average person in North America, hang on. See, this symbolism of nuclear is not a representation of potassium-40 or rubidium or carbon or nickel or anything else that's natural on the planet. That stuff were acclimated through genetic superior selection. Everything in these symbols, everything on the planet, has a visceral reaction to it. Their body attacks it relentlessly for decades and floods itself with white blood cells, displacing the oxygen in the red blood cells, allowing 1,800 autoimmune diseases and deficiencies to show up before the cancer manifests. Australian forecast. I mean, this is a typical nuclear or university professor or media pundit when it comes to nuclear. This is what they really look like when you go home at night. What you got to do is you got to say no, 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 no. You got to get in their faces. When they say bananas, you got to say no and leave. You got to say, I want my money back. You're here lying. They're burning it in the incinerators in Japan. They're burning it. This is the dust coming over. I think this one in particular. No, this is Fukushima, right? I got one coming up on dust. Is government trying to contaminate every region of Japan? Got to remember that the forest fires. Think about when they have forest fires in Japan or Asia, it comes across and adds to your pollution indexes. Because the jet streams and the Pacific corridors are real. They're actually real. They studied it through pollution. They studied it through industrial pollution from automobiles and factories come to North America and add to your pollution indexes for months at a time. It lingers all over your country and deposits it pollution all over your country. And it does that with dust. They've done big studies on dust coming over from Asia. These particles, like forest fires, like pollution from automobiles from Asia, like dust coming over from Asia, these are thousands of times bigger than the man-made stuff. And we produce, in those reactors, each of those reactors was 5 million pounds every 18 months to 20 months. And they take it out and put it on the roof, 5 million pounds at a time. The official story, like the official pictures, was full of lies. The official story now is they got around 1,100 rods there. Each reactor has 2,800 rods. Each rod is 18 pounds each and 12 feet long. There's 4,340 assemblies in each of those plants. Each assembly got 80 rods. And so a pound of this rod, if you put it in a building with 1,500 people, you kill everybody in the building in 20 minutes. Everybody in the front row in 1 minute, everybody in the back row by then and in between is dead in 20 minutes. Drag all the bodies out and do that perpetually till the end of time, get rid of everybody and then all the animals on the planet. And that rod will still be vicious, still be deadly. That's why we want you to come out. That's why we want some kind of solution. Because that's why we have terrorist laws. That's why we spend billions of dollars at each plant on security. Meanwhile, Japan is allowed to burn it in the incinerators and send it over here like the forest fires, like the automobile pollution that comes over, like the sandstorms that come over. Fukushima will start burning radioactive waste, 100,000 becquerels a kilogram, to be incinerated. 1 billion pounds of debris. That's not counting the 30 million one-ton bags. And a lot of that stuff, they're storing it at the incinerator sites. Japan is burning stuff at their site, full-time, 24 hours a day. They'll take nuclear fuel rods and everything, and put it in there. The material from the detonations. And they'll burn that too. All the highly contaminated stuff, they'll bring it over on a remote control forklift and they'll drop it in the incinerator and burn it. As long as the winds are blowing in North America, right? That's the time to do it. That's what they've done. That's what's happening. But according to the ocean, the wind can change and blow it right back in again. Blow it all over China to the right of it. And blow it all over Vietnam to the left of it and the Philippines and everywhere else. Well, the Philippines are first and Vietnam is behind that. The typhoons is picking it up and liberating it throughout the entire country. The storms are washing it out of the trees and the mountains and the streams. But like, if I take a section of land and I sprinkle radiation over that land, what happens? It irradiates the trees, irradiates them. So you know how you take a screwdriver and you put it on a battery, hook up a few wires to it, now you can have a magnetized screwdriver. It's really simple. Radiation does the same thing when it falls on stuff. That's why we have transgenic waste, right? By the way, WHIP is planning on putting plutonium 238 down to WHIP. But WHIP was licensed for what? Transgenic waste, like clothing and contaminated hammers and contaminated equipment from nuclear power plants. Not for nuclear waste, see? But here they are claiming they're going to put that down there now. They claim there was no releases, and they're still wearing suits to go down there because there's releases. They're claiming there's no releases, and they can't change the filter because it's too radioactive. They're claiming no releases, but 90 people had internal radiation doses. They're claiming no radiation releases, only a little tiny bit, like no damage outside of the plant itself. But yet, the accident happened on a week before they announced it. A week before, there was a truck fire. Everybody left the WHIP, the waste repository, in New Mexico. Right. Because you had a truck fire where there's 55 football fields. You had a football field, just a single one. There was a truck fire on the other end, truck fire. And all you got to do is move 20 feet and you're out of the direction of the wind. You're fine. They abandoned the mine for a whole week. Because it was radiation, not a truck fire. So the radiation was allowed to come out of there. We got the videos of it pouring out of the buildings from the mine shaft. So unbelievable lies, unbelievable manipulation, unbelievable deception, and unbelievable arrogance and contempt they have for you. And just hatred, just fucking hatred. They're just full of hatred. They demonized me and vilified me for saying, hey, wait a second. Why did you abandon 55 football fields for a truck fire? KRQE Channel 13 come out and pummeled me for that one. Because I broke it down. I showed the documentation of what was going on. And anybody knows this if you look at it. If you have a detonation on the ground of nuclear waste, you got to get out of there. You can't get back in there. That's the problem with nuclear. It's the stupidest thing imaginable. That's why they got to lie to you. Anybody who tells you like a banana, why do you sit there and take it? Why do you put up with it? Why do you allow yourself and your friends and your families and everyone around you to be humiliated by allowing that person to continue that? Like if CBC or BBC or CBS put someone out there, why don't a million people get in their fucking faces? Twitter out and blast them. Because people don't know any better. They've got 70 years of brainwashing and manipulating. But now that you know better, now that you understand there is a difference, and that it's an insult to you. That's what it's meant as. It's meant to ridicule you and to trick you. That's all it's meant to do. It's meant to deceive you. And that's Like, when you give your loved ones chemotherapy, you sign a piece of paper saying, go ahead and kill my child, I can't sue you now. Or my friend or my family or myself. You can't kill. That's what chemotherapy is. You take a nuclear waste. I'm supposed to be on a nuclear waste site till the end of time. You're injecting it into someone's body. How fucking stupid and gullible are you? Only because you believed in the media, you believed in your doctor, you believed in the nuclear industry, you believed it was like a banana. Why don't you put bananas in you if you get sick? Why don't you fill up my room full of bananas if I get sick? Will that make me better? What are you, moronic? What are you, stupid? If I fill my house up with nuclear waste, will I feel better? If I eject it into me, will that make me feel better? Will that make me better? How can it? Look at Dr. Raymond Gilmedi's studies on beagle dogs and beagle puppies. I'm just going to start yelling. Better not. I just get so pissed off. I get so frustrated. And they all get all the traction out there as long as they do that. I'm here bringing you the truth, and I have to beg all the time to raise money to do anything. And they get it given to them. They can do whatever they want, long as it's law, as long as it's manipulation, as long as it's deception. They can get all the money is given to them. If I come out and ask for it, I'm an e-bagger. But I'm on a site where 90 million other people have a donate button, but I'm the bad guy because I got one. It's really shocking, you know? There's a link directly to my PayPal under my videos on Beautiful Girl by Dana on YouTube. 300 times more radiation released into the atmosphere from burning debris than claimed by the government, and you can donate at the nuclear proctologist with your credit cards. We've been doing that for 2 years, totally legit. It funded 5 expeditions along the coastline of British Columbia, Canada. And that just on its own is amazing. Chernobyl's with the world's worst. This is 2006, Vidal, John Vidal. 20 years on, Vidal reports on the cleanup, the false medical records, and the communities that refuse to leave, and the continuing cost to people and planet, and planet, and planet. Look at your third sentence. For the next 10 days, spewed equivalent of 400 Hiroshima bombs worth of radioactivity across 150,000 square miles of Europe and beyond. 150,000. So look at this study. For 200 miles of the coastline, and because they didn't find the urchins or they weren't in abundance, the Smithsonian National Geographic declared a mass mortality because of 200 miles. Okay. We covered 15,000 miles in a little dinky. And instead of being just amazing, inconceivable, unimaginable, like it has been for billions of years, just unbelievable, inconceivably gorgeous, it was naked. These are all from Louise Narrows and the Queen Charlottes. This is when I was up there on the expedition. Here's a little zodiac on the beach. All gone. And that bird that was over my head that day, he's not going to find anything to eat, is he? It's not like he can just go land anywhere like it used to be. He can go land anywhere and find something to eat, yeah? Used to be amazing. Used to be everywhere. Every millimeter, every square inch. Now, that same spot, 5 years after, well, that was 4 years after Fukushima when I took these pictures and that picture. We took 3,000 pictures of Louise Narrows because Louise Narrows is at the top of that page there. On your left-hand side of the arrows, pointing out towards the ocean, in red, there's a bunch, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 little arrows there at the bottom of that archipelago of islands, at the top right-hand side of, now I created that chart as just a representation. We spent 2 months in that group of islands, in this boat, not we, me, by myself, and the hounds of Fukushima and people all over the world supporting us. And we done that whole coastline. And instead of looking like that, it was all gone. Every bit of it. Gone permanently, too. And they're still burning it in the incinerators. There's no one to hold them accountable. Only us. That's it. We're the blowback. Fukushima plant will burn radioactive waste right around the clock. Okay, stream's over, I guess. Japan's secret promise with the U.S. to burn plutonium. Don't matter. They're burning it at the all over the place anyway. Includes, this is at the incinerator to run around the clock, right? Now at the same time, think about this headline. Japan's secret promise with the U.S. to burn plutonium, but they're also burning all the radioactive waste right at the Fukushima plant, so they're going to be burning that plutonium right there. That's what they're up to. And where does that go? That comes right across the ocean to North America, yeah? You better believe it. If the information, the documentation I showed you doesn't make you understand that this is not like a banana, not like a radio banana, it's because you've been coerced and tricked and deceived by the thugs that come across as little angels that are dare to harm you, like those baby ducks, chicklets. Well, let's come over and say good day to everybody. We're at the weekend. I'm probably too tired to go out in the boat this weekend. I'm just burnt out from trying to get this stream the last 2 days. I'm literally worn out. Now it says the live stream has ended. But we're not in it, so I'll just move that over. We'll say hi to everybody. We'll call it a day. It was a good stream. Like you say, right up to the very last second. It took me right to the very last second before I got the stream to work. Yesterday was a nightmare 25 minutes. I think I got that solved. I'm pretty sure though. But like I say, it was such a big struggle. It just took so much out of me. And at the same time, I was finishing up the boat. I wanted to go out this weekend and do a bird count, the bird species count for 2 days. It's probably the only good weather we're going to see like that for a long time. Who knows, could be all good weather for another couple of months because of summer coming. Hello to everybody. Thank you, Pam. White Sparrow. Bruce. Zipfree. Terry Ann. Nova. Hi, Terry. Nova. Nolan. Shanigan, Hugsfree Lane. I'll bring up the other camera so I don't look like a total dork, I suppose. Hugsfree Lane. Thank you, honey. Mickey, Nep Killer, Bruce. Remember, folks, you can donate for Kate at the Fukushima Hounds. It's time to start taking care of that lady, too. Give her a little. Everybody donated $5 or $10 to her, for goodness sakes. You consider all the work she has done, how she supported us when we were on the ocean as a rallying point for everybody. I hope everybody can find it. You'll find links below my YouTube videos at Beautiful Girl by Dana, directly to her PayPal account, and that'll always be there from here on out. So hugs for everybody. Take care, folks. Thank you, everybody. Zigfree, everybody. Mickey, Shanikan, Terry Ann. I know I missed all kinds of people, but hey. Nip Killer, illusion is over. Did I miss anybody? Chuck. Andres. And everybody else I didn't say hi to. Thank you for having the patience the last couple of days. I know it's been a nightmare. I know. I haven't stopped. But I still might make some day trips out onto the ocean. I'll just end up with that for the weekend. But I don't know if I'll be going out and spending a night on the ocean. I'll go out and spend a few hours. I just want to go out and see how many birds I can find. See if there's any fish jumping. See if there's any activity. Talk to a few fishermen along the way. And just get away from what I do all day, every day. And since we come ashore, it's been 5 months since I made a couple of short trips out and done bird counts. Were devastating already, but not like I want to do right now this weekend. But it looks like, who knows, we'll try. Hugs for everybody. I'll catch everybody on Monday at livestream.com. I'm Dana Durnford, the nuclear proctologist. Find a higher quality up at beautiful girl by Dana on YouTube.